Live from Bob Hanna Stadium, it is Senior Day and the 2019 Delaware baseball season finale here on Hens All Access. Delaware trying to wrap up their season with a win over the College of Charleston Cougars. As Adam Dabrowski here, thanking you so much for tuning in today. Delaware before the game honored five in the upcoming class to graduate for this Delaware program, all five making positive contributions to the program, and they hope to send out those seniors with a victory. On the bump, though, it'll be a freshman in Joey Seilin going up against the Charleston lineup. But first, let's get you the numbers on Seilin, the product of Caravelle Academy, owns a 3-5 record, a 5.87 ERA, and a .262 batting average allowed, over 61 and a third innings. His record, though, an even 500 against Colonial foes. Seilin has 42 walks and 51 strikeouts over the 61 and a third innings, and he goes up against the following lineup for Charleston. As the Cougars, they've already locked up the number 2 seed for the upcoming Colonial tournament. They have a few adjustments, a few days off for some of their top hitters, but Luke Manzo, Bradley Dixon, Joey Mundy, and Chaz Davey, a quartet of seniors, they are the first four in the lineup today for the Cougars. Harrison Hawkins, Tanner Steffi, Ari Sakopoulos have seen some time during the series on and off. They are hitters 5 through 7, and then batters 8 and 9 see their first action of the weekend. The freshman catcher, Jared Kirvin, and the sophomore second baseman, Luke Stagaberg. Your umpires for today's game at home plate, you have Alex Scandalis. The first base umpire is Brian Marine, and the third base umpire, Brian DeBrower. To lead things off, it'll be Luke Manzo. Manzo, over the first two games in the series, very productive from the 9 spot in the lineup. And in fact, he had the go-ahead 2-run double Thursday night in Charleston's 10-7 16-inning victory. Manzo takes a first pitch ball inside at 12:01 p.m. And we're underway here in Newark, Delaware. Game time temperature today of 73 degrees with mostly sunny skies, as Seilin's 1-0 offering taken for a strike. One, and that one is low. Let's look at the field for Delaware. In the outfield from left to right, you have Jordan Hutchins, Kevin Mulholland, and Austin Colmeri. The infield will have after the 2-1 pitch. And this is swung on and sent out to left. Hutchins tracking back near the track, makes the catch, and there's one away. Your infield from left to right, you have Zach Lesher, Vinny Vaccone, Eric Bowron, and Joseph Carpenter. Your battery today, the same as Thursday's game. Jack Goen, the catcher, and the pitcher, Joey Solano. Actually, not the same battery, the same catcher, I should say, to be more accurate, but Seilin, the pitcher here for the third game of the series. And his first pitch offering to Bradley Dixon is taken for a strike. Dixon playing in both games, both from the number 2 spot in the lineup. His batting average now to .318. 54 hits and 170 at-bats. And he sends this out to left for a base hit. So the first base runner on safely early in this game. As Charleston, they'll look for the sweep here and head into the Colonial Tournament on an 8-game winning streak. Meanwhile, Delaware, indeed, it's their season finale after falling yesterday 5-0 after a stellar performance of 6 hitless innings from Griffin McLarty and a pair of home runs to help out along the way. Delaware hoping to avoid the sweep and finish things off in winning fashion for the 5 honored for Senior Day: Kevin Mulholland, Eric Bowron, Matt Rikicheski, Cole Benjamin, and Brandon Walter. Look to second in the 1-0 pitch. Nice breaking ball. Swing and a miss for Joey Mundy, who, boy, he's been really red hot as of late. 13 of 21 batting over his last 6 starts in the Charleston lineup. He started yesterday and hit a solo home run to right field, which was the go-ahead RBI. Throw to first, and Dixon back safely. Mundy's average now to 354 over a limited sample size, 48 at-bats. And the 1-1 pitch taken for a strike. Mundy began his collegiate career with the Vanderbilt Commodores out in the SEC. But Mundy now taking his talents from Tennessee to South Carolina and helping out Charleston late in the senior season as the runner goes on the 1-2 pitch. It's fished out to left field, caught, and a chance here for two, and completed, F7-3. As Jordan Hutchins able to turn that routine fly out into a double play. The hit and run worked during a 5-run inning in the second on Thursday. Didn't work out there, though, for the Cougars. They have no runs, one hit, no errors, none left. We'll keep it here as Delaware coming up to bat on Hens All Access. Get you the starting lineup for Delaware. It's been the same starting nine in the same order throughout this series. Kevin Mulholland and Eric Bowren, two seniors, playing in their final game in a Hens uniform, batting 240 and 246 respectively. They lead off the lineup. Jordan Hutchins and Joseph Carpenter, two very promising underclassmen, get to start today, and they will have started all 54 games this season for the Hens. Meanwhile, we have Jack Goen and Zach Miller. They've been splitting things up between catcher and DH. Goen, the catcher, and Miller, DH today. And then Vinny Vaccone, Zach Lesher, and Austin Colmeri close out the lineup. They'll be going up against the sophomore lefty arm for Charleston and Zach Williams. A 3-3 record, a 4.74 ERA, and a .280 batting average allowed this season over 9 starts and 4 relief appearances. Williams has pitched 49 and a third innings, allowing 26 earned runs, 53 hits, 16 walks, and 19 strikeouts. That last particular ratio, given his innings pitched, very much suggests Williams a good control pitcher, but he loves to put the ball in play. And we'll see how Delaware handles things there. Currently facing a streak of 22 consecutive team at-bats without a run scored. Came in an untimely fashion the last 13 innings of that marathon game Thursday night. A tough matchup yesterday, but unable to get a run was their opportunity to make the postseason tournament came to an end yesterday. But Kevin Mulholland, he will lead things off. Mulholland getting the start today. He now has started all but one of his games as a Blue Hen in his 4-year career. The product of Rose Valley, Pennsylvania, takes a first pitch strike. 220 games played, 219 starts. He has tied the program record for most games played as a Delaware Blue Hen. 0-1 pitch, fouls it away. Mulholland also in the top four in overall at bats as a Blue Hen and walks, and he ranks 14th in the program history for hits with 241. Try to make it 242, but sent over to third and picked up on a hop. As Chaz Davey able to field it, it's a 5-3 ground out, and there's one away. Let's look at the Charleston field from left to right. In the outfield, you have Joey Mundy, Harrison Hawkins, and Bradley Dixon. The infield has Chaz Davey, Luke Manzo, Luke Stagerberg, and Ari Sakopoulos. In your battery, Jared Kirvin, the catcher, and the pitcher, Zach Williams, as Eric Bowren sends another one over to third. Two up, two down. We'll talk more about Bowren the next time he's up to bat, but he was one of the 5 seniors honored, and Bowren playing his last 2 seasons with Delaware after coming over from Mercer County Community College, which back in 2017 made the NJCAA Division II World Series. Jordan Hutchins now up to bat, and Hutchins swings and fouls away the first pitch. rapid start for Williams. His first four pitches are strikes. The lefty winds, kicks, and delivers. And this again is sent over to third. Davey will make it a 1-2-3 inning with all 5-3 groundouts. So we have no score through one here on Hens All Access.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
It took us just 16 pitches to get through one inning. Joey Seiland allowed a single in the first, but then got an F7-3 double play to end the inning. So 10 pitches in his opening frame. He goes up against the middle third of the Charleston lineup. And his first pitch swinging foul by Chaz Davey, who's still looking for his first hit of the series. But he's been batting very well in his senior campaign. 278 hitter. And an on-base plus slugging of 656. Sorry, 756, I should say. Sends this one to shallow outfield. Vinny Vaccone calls for it. Eventually settles underneath to record the P6, and there's one away. Again, Adam Dobrovolsky here, thanking you so much for tuning in, not just today, but this series and this season on Hens All Access. The 2018-2019 athletic season nearing its end, and boy, it came by very quickly. First pitch swinging off speed, and that's missed by Harrison Hawkins, a 257 batter. In center field today after Chris Graham got the first two starts dead center for Charleston in this series. 0-1, and that's fouled away. Been a very exciting year for Blue Hens Athletics. In particular for baseball, the biggest sign of positivity this season, despite not making conference tournament, was how they responded to adversity this season. 0-2. Pitch misses low and away for a ball. Delaware started the season losing his first 13 games. Has responded since then with a winning record, and they only had two batters with at least 200 at-bats of Division I batting experience. 1-2 pitch sent up the middle, but Vaccone is there. And he gets the assist this time after the putout. 6-3 the ground out, 2 up, 2 down, top of the second, no score. But of the two players, one went down in the first game, Kyle Baker with a torn labrum, and Kevin Mulholland, the lone batter throughout the remaining part of the season, to have that experience, but many other have now gotten to that point. As the starting nine's been routine the last two weekends. First pitch swinging, and Tanner Steffi is a base runner. Sends it opposite field between the hole at first and second for the second single of the game for Charleston. Charleston and the first game of the series was very aggressive in terms of early swinging against Brandon Walter, who was honored before the game today for Senior Day. Walter surpassing the triple-digit mark for strikeouts this season, just the fourth Hens pitcher to do so, and did so in his first year back, returning from Tommy John surgery. So a very impressive season for Walter. And right now, a similar approach to Joey Silent on the bump, early swinging, and this 1-0 pitch by Ari Sakopoulos will slice foul down the right field line. Sakopoulos, a junior, batting .216 this season, over 97 at-bats. A left-handed hitter, he's seen time in both games as a reserve on Thursday and as a starter yesterday. You have Tanner Steffi, the freshman, at first, fresh off his ninth hit as a Cougar. And this one by Sakopoulos sent back to Mahalan, who tracks back and will make the catch to end the inning. So a two-out single and nothing more for the Cougars. No runs, one hit, no errors, one left. Delaware looking for its first run of the game, coming up to bat on your turn on Hens All Access.
America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Delaware has the middle third of its lineup due. And the bottom of the second going up against Zach Williams, who had six pitches, six strikes. Of those six pitches, three in play, and there were 3-5-3 ground outs recorded. Joseph Carpenter leads off for the Hens, leading the team with a .300 batting average in his freshman season. And he takes a first pitch ball. Carpenter unable to reach safely in yesterday's game, just the second time over the last 80% of the season. Now the count 1-1. He lines it over to third. It's been a busy start for Chaz Davey, but he gets the L5. And there's now one away.
Number 24, the catcher, Jack Gold.
Three assists and a putout so far for Davey at the hot corner. Jack Goen due up, and he takes a first pitch ball outside. Williams working quickly, and Goen sends it over to third. Davey fires over to first, and there's two up, two down. Right now, Chaz Davey getting the best practice possible, one would think, just to keep that routine motion going. Davey started Thursday's game at first. That one was replaced defensively by Ari Sakopoulos. Started at third yesterday, and then he was replaced defensively by Clay Hunt. Zach Miller takes a first pitch ball, and it's now three consecutive first pitch balls for Williams. 1-0, and this ball is put into play, and hey, it's out to right field. And that'll be grabbed in F9. So Chaz Davey, a well-earned playoff for the Cougars offensively. And Zach Williams making quick work so far through two innings of work. Delaware down in order again. We go to the third when we return on Hens All Access. Joey Silen back on the bump as we go to the top of the third inning. And for the first time this series, we'll see the freshman catcher for Charleston, Jared Kervin, who's 3 of 27 at the plate this season. First pitch swinging and sends it over the leap of Eric Bowron into right center for maybe two here. Aggressive base running by Kervin, and he gets a leadoff double. No qualms about settling for a single, and the hustle shown by the Charleston catcher. I know you put all this pressure on your knees when you're catching, but Kervin showing some fresh legs there early in this game. So a leadoff double, the first extra base hit of the game. And now you'll have Luke Stagerberg up to bat, making just his second start. 4 of 10 at the plate so far in his sophomore season with one double. By the way, that double for Kervin, his first extra base hit recorded this season as a freshman. Oh, 1. Check swing was held back as it goes into the turf. And so the count is even to Stagerberg. Chad Holbrook, the head coach of Charleston, going with quite a different look in today's lineup with things pretty much all sealed up for these two sides. 1-1 is a strike taken on the outside half. It's an opportunity for two different things. One, to get a different look at some players that haven't gotten as many at-bats this season, and you don't know what will come into play in Colonial Tournament action, so you want to give those guys some experience. 1-2, and this will be chopped over to short. Should advance the runner. Vacone with the throw, able to beat out Stagerberg by maybe a step, step and a half, and there's one away. But the other thing is you give a chance to give some of your regulars some rest. The likes of Danny Wondrak come to mind, as well as Dupree Hart, Chris Graham. All did a really good job. Logan McRae as well. All getting rest today after earning their worth, not just the series, but the regular season. They get a chance to get the breather before taking the flight back to the Palmetto State and then get ready to head back up to Virginia for tournament play. Count is 0-1 as the infield is in. Ball squirts slightly away from going, but not enough to advance Kirvin home. And so the count 1-1 to Luke Manzo, who's batting leadoff today. And he's 0-1 so far with a fly out to left. 1-1, and this is sent out to left center. This will fall through to send home the run. Manzo's going to round first. Here comes the throw to second. Tag is applied in time. So that'll be an outfield assist. But first, it's an RBI single for Luke Manzo to make the score 1-0. Two outs, bases empty here in the top of the third. Manzo's had good contact on both of his swings in play. And that one found the right spot when the first one didn't. Comes in obviously better context with an RBI opportunity. So Luke Manzo with his 24th RBI of the season. Charleston now with the lead. Bradley Dixon fouls off the first pitch. He singled in his first at-bat to improve his batting average to .322. Oh, one, and that's low and away. To close out that play, the out that was recorded went 8-4, so the outfield assist to Kevin Mulholland. One, and this fouled back. So far, both pitchers throwing to contact. Teams are swinging early and middle in counts. And there have been many strikeout opportunities, but there's one here, and the 1-2 pitch misses low and away. So here now the 2-2. And this fouled away. The Colonial Tournament picture not yet wrapped up, although Charleston, they have their business handled. They're the number 2 seed. Elon's the 1 seed, but Northeastern, they're in at 12-11. Then there's a trio of teams at 11-12. William & Mary, James Madison, and UNCW. Followed by Hofstra at 10-13. Four teams fighting for three spots heading into the weekend finales. Hofstra and William & Mary have no score top second. And then at 1:00, you'll see another game in action. And that one, I believe, is the UNCW James Madison matchup. That or the Northeastern Towson matchup, one or the other. It's actually Northeastern Towson that starts at 1. James Madison and UNCW begins at 2. A lengthy battle here between Bradley Dixon and Joey Silent, which is by and far the longest plate appearance of this game, albeit early. 2-2, sent out to center field. Kevin Mulholland settles underneath to make the catch, and the inning comes to an end. But Luke Manzo driving home, and his freshman catcher teammate Jared Kirvin for the first run of the game. Charleston gets the run on two hits. There are no errors and none left in the top of the third. We go bottom three when we return on Hens All Access.
Oh. So you guys have recently started dating?
Yes. Yeah. A little less than a month.
Coming up on 2 months now, yeah.
Cool. I want to show you guys these three Chevy SUVs. The first one is called the Trax.
Beautiful.
Do you think it would be good for moving in together?
Moving in together?
Okay. Well, this is the Chevy Equinox.
Wow. Nice.
Perfect for when you two have your first kid.
Give me some time.
Okay. This is the Traverse for when you have your 5 kids, 2 dogs, and 1 cat.
Oh. 5?
Well, no matter what stage of life you're in, Chevy has an SUV for you.
We have it all planned out. Thanks.
Vinny Vaccone leads things off. Bottom three for Delaware is now the Hens trail against the College of Charleston. Vaccone had a 3-hit game on Thursday. Hitless yesterday. His batting average now 256 in his junior season. Second with the Hens after spending a year at Mercer County, being the middle infield teammate of Eric Bowen when they made their World Series run. Mercer County finished as the runners-up in 2017. 0-2, quickly the count, and the pitch outside for a ball. And this actually here, the fourth pitch of the plate appearance to Vinny Vaccone will be the longest so far for Zach Williams. Pitch misses for a ball. Well, it had to happen.
Well, Philly from here is 45.
2-2. And that gets away to make the count full as the first bit of control issues. Limited so far, obviously, for Williams. Working from the windup. Here's the kick and the payoff pitch. Taken for ball four. Vinny Vaccone becomes the first base runner for Delaware, and it's a leadoff walk, so we see how the Hens will go with this one with Zach Lesher due up. Lesher, the second generation Delaware baseball player. Coached by former MLB-er Brian Lesher at the high school level, and yes, you can connect the dots, Zach and Brian. Zach being second generation University of Delaware baseball player, indeed father and son. First pitch is a ball low. And now it's 5 balls thrown in a row by Williams. Lesher. Slowly chops a ball foul. So swinging right now, not bunting for the redshirt freshman. The left-handed hitter at 195 on the season. And a 9-game hit streak recently. A pair of multi-hit games that went through the first game of the Hofstra series. But looking for some hits since then. And the 1-1 pitch taken low for a ball. Trying to get that batting average back over the Mendoza line. It's been a patient hitter, though. 17 walks drawn this season. And the lefty versus lefty matchup will lead to a high chopper. Tried to get the lead runner, and that was a poor decision by Sakopoulos. Might not have had a chance to go to first anyway, but not in time. The throw's a bit wide as well. All hands are safe. Two on, nobody out, with Austin Colmeri due up. The first thought that pops into the mind is fielder's choice reach will get the confirmation of the scoring call. And indeed, that's it from our scorer, Eric Oakley. First pitch is a strike to Austin Colmeri. Colmeri is Delaware's leader in on-base percentage. 421. He's a 269 hitter overall. And Colmeri, another redshirt freshman. He was a hero for Post One in the American Legion World Series this past summer with the walk-off RBI single to win the state's first ever American Legion World Series championship. Colmary goes for the bunt, and that's a good play by the freshman catcher to take charge. Kerbin fires it over to first for a 2-4 sacrifice. And an effective play by Colmary flips the lineup over for the senior, Kevin Mahalan. Mahalan in his first at bat grounded out to third. On the season, Mahalan with 25 RBI sends it over to first. And now I'll make it number 26 as a foot on the bag by Sakopoulos. Makes it two away, but Vinny Vaccone comes in to score to tie it up at one. Eric Boren now up to bat. Boren, another one of the seniors honored. Takes a first pitch ball. He grounded out to third on a first pitch swing back in the first inning. Now batting 245 on the season, and Boren's been a reliable bat and arm in the middle infield. A little buckle of the knee. He takes a pitch inside half for a called strike. But an RBI opportunity here for Boren, who has 24 on the season. He fouls this pitch off to make the count 1-2. Delaware scoring in this third inning snapped the streak of 24 consecutive scoreless team at-bats. They had 7 in the first 3 of the series. And that's the thing about baseball. Sometimes trends can make a quick 180. That one didn't miss by much, but it is a ball, and Boren now has an even count, 2-2. Williams with the pitch, and that's sent over to short. Throw will be in time, as it's been an impressive series at short for Luke Manzo. But Delaware, they get on the board without a hit. They score a run. There were no errors. And for the Hens, one left on base. We are tied at 1-3 on Hens All Access. Third. Back an even score, each side scoring in the third. Into the fourth we go. And the heart of the Charleston lineup on this Saturday afternoon. to begin this fourth inning against Joey Silin, who offers a first pitch outside. Joey Monday up. He flew out 7-3 into a double play. And he sends it over inside fair territory down the right field line. Just beyond the reach of Carpenter, it's into the corner, makes it an easy leadoff double for Mundy, who he's now 14 of 23 in his last seven starts batting. Boy, is he seeing the ball oh so well down the stretch. Could be a huge asset for the Cougars and the Colonial Tournament, and they already shape up pretty well for tournament play with 20 come from behind victories, a bevy of two RBIs over the last 12 games, which is at about 2.5 RBIs in the last 12 games. And this sent over to the foul territory, first base, the leap out of room for Joseph Carpenter with Chaz Davey up to bat. But the comeback ability, the two-out ability, but also Charleston, they've been very strong in one- or two-run games, winning about 2 out of 3 this season. That's another check in your list there to see if they really are a huge threat in tournament play. 0-1 offering misses low to Davey. Davey popped out to short in his first time to the plate. One-one, and that misses low and away. Cougars going up against Joey Silin, who in his last two starts have had effective outings against UNC Wilmington. 8 innings, just 2 runs allowed on 4 hits, 5 walks, 8 strikeouts. 2-1, that one got away from Silin. Hits the back of Davey, and quickly 2-1, nobody out here in the fourth. Harrison Hawkins is now coming up. I think that's actually the first time Davies reached safely in the series, so he has to do it the hard way, but he'll take it. Harrison Hawkins going up against double play depth, will try to bunt, pops it up, and just beyond the reach of Jack Gowen. Break there for the Cougars. They have struggled this series bunting, which, to be honest, is quite surprising. They've been rather adept at hit and run. They've been good on the base paths, and you think if they can execute their bunting situations come tournament play, that's just another facet that makes them a threat beyond the basic hitting and pitching ability, which they can do both. L1. This gets into the turf, going for a split second, lost location on the ball, but it was right underneath him. No advancement. And now the count is even. One one. Now a sign of bunt. Hawkins sends it wide, foul. One two. Silin, a look to second from the stretch. Here's the pitch, and it's a chopper over to third. Lesher will just get the tag. Because he had to wait, he had no other throw, but he gets the force. Monday is off. He's out on the base paths, and there's one away. Davey to second, Hawkins to first on the fielder's choice. Five unassisted, obviously, on that. And Tanner Steffi, one swing, one single so far in this day, up to bat. An RBI opportunity for Tanner Steffi as he takes a first pitch strike. A limited sample size with runners in scoring position, but a 200 batting average. Three RBIs on the season and 30 at-bats. Oh, one. And that misses low for a ball. Steffi from Chapin, South Carolina. Oh, wait, it's the 1-1 pitch from Silen, who is one of several players right here from Newark. You have six players. He played for St. Mark's. Not all of them, though, from Newark. You have some of the Newark products going to Caravelle Academy, like Silen, who's on the bump, also Brad Caden. You have Zach Lesher, who went to Newark Charter. Then you have guys like Chris Ludman, Justin Tomovich, who went to St. Mark's. 1-2. And that misses low. So the count is even again. Double play depth for the Hens. They can end this inning on a swing. And Silence pitches high. The count is now full. We have seen Charleston aggressive on the base paths this series. They entered the series, in fact, top 10 in the nation in stolen bases. We'll see with one out if they'll try to go with a full count. And Silen able to get a runner in the pickle. Spin move attempt, but Chaz Davey is out on the base paths, alert running by Harrison Hawkins to go to second. But perhaps you saw there Davey dancing a little bit away in the pitch for Silen. And the best thing to do there is kind of slow down the pace, keep the base runner antsy, and hope things work out in your favor. And that was the case. So Davey picked off, caught stealing. Two away now. And a runner at second with a payoff pitch fouled by Steffi. It goes 1-5-6-1 on the pickoff caught stealing. Payoff pitch again. This is sent over to third. Lesher unable to handle it. Took a high hop and went off his glove. Hawkins is going to round third, come home to score. Moving to second, Steffi. He'll have at least a single. We'll see if it's ruled a double. Depends on if he was rounding second on the throw or before. Either way, Charleston back ahead. It's 2-1. And that's an E5 on the play. Lasher's been very reliable at third in these last two weekends. But that one just featured a little bit of indecision and then a misread of the hop. So it's actually not a single. I just said that without thinking twice about the actual play. It's a straight E5. Doesn't matter if Steffi advanced on the throw or rounded before the throw. It's an error. Ari Sakopoulos up. He swings at the 0-1 pitch. Silen picks it up with the glove and tosses with the bare hand to make it a 1-3 ground out. And the inning comes to an end. But Charleston, they get the lead back on an unearned run. Scored on a hit and an error. And there was one left on base. Middle four. Cougars back ahead by a run. Jordan Hutchins leads things off for Delaware, with the Hens trailing once again. It's now 2-1. They trailed 1-0 going into the bottom of the third, scored a run, thanks to a leadoff walk by Vinny Vaccone and a fielder's choice reach. Hutchins had a lone hit yesterday. And he sends it over to third. Chaz Davey makes it the fifth. 5-3 ground out of the game, but his first since that string of four assists and one put out of the first five outs recorded. Hutchins goes down, out 0-2. And Joseph Carpenter due up. It's been a struggle for the Hens offense down the stretch here against what's been a very strong Charleston pitching staff. 1-0 taken for a strike. Carpenter had bases loaded, bottom of the 11th in Thursday night's game, struck out looking. 1-1. Since then, over the span of the last 17 team at bats, Delaware has gone hitless 15 out of those 17 team at bats. 1-2, and Carpenter fouls it away. Carpenter lined out to third, his first time to the plate. And he fouls another one away. Strikeout here makes it 2-up, 2-down. And the fourth. Jack Goin now up to bat. Goin grounded out 5-3. That, by the way, the first strikeout for either side. Both Silen and Williams have done a good job of drawing contact early like this here for Goin, and guess who? Chaz Davey, 5-3 ground out. So the Hens go down in order, 1-2-3. We are through four, and the Cougars up by a run on Hens All Access.
Buffalo's first six-function multi-pro tailgate, available only on the next generation GMC Sierra. During GMC's Truck Month, get 0% financing on most GMC Sierra and Canyon models, or get over $9,500 total value on this next generation Sierra SLT when you finance through GM Financial. GMC, Truck Month like a pro.
There was a scoring change on the sequence in the top of the fourth. No E5 on Zach Lesher. The hop just went over him. Doesn't touch the glove. Doesn't lead to an error. So Tanner Steffi gets credited with an RBI double in the fourth. That gave Charleston the 2-1 lead. They're trying to extend it here in the fifth. And it's a first pitch strike from Joey Seilin to the freshman catcher, Jared Kirvin. Kirvin doubled in his first at-bat and scored a run. Takes one on the turf here, and the count is even. So it's now two earned runs allowed on six hits through four innings for Seilin. He's also hit a batter, but no walks, no strikeouts so far. Check swing went too far. Kirvin actually almost went full swing there, trying to hold it back, as he got fooled by Seilin, and the count's 1-2. Chopped over to short, and make that third. Lesher taking charge, and as a result, able to get the ground out. Good communication between Lesher and Vacone. It would have been harder for Vacone to get the throw. And so Kirvin down 5-3. First assist by Lesher in this game. While Chaz Davey on the other side, he's been very, very busy. Luke Stagenberg tries to get the bunt. Seilin will let it roll. So will Lesher, and it's going to hit the bag fair. Perfectly placed bunt single for Stagenberg. I mean, that couldn't get any better for Charleston. Delaware did the right thing. It was not in the dirt, but in the dirt area, so to say, quote unquote, of the turf, with the all-turf field here at Bob Hanna Stadium. And it just kept rolling fair. Perfectly done as the lineup flips over to Luke Manzo. And now Stagenberg marks the seventh hit for Charleston. It's now 18-1 hitting in the last two games between these two sides. And Manzo takes a first pitch ball. Stagenberg becoming the sixth different Cougar to hit. And was the first two times through the lineup against Joey Seilin, as a head first dive back safely for Stagenberg. Seilin has not allowed any more than 8 hits in an outing. It happened twice. One at Elon, one against Villanova. Both, unfortunately, in losing efforts, but Seilin trying to keep it limited here. He has his defense at double play depth with one out, so he can end the inning on a swing. From the stretch, Timeout called as the motion was just about to get started. It was completed by Silent. Check swing. That one held back, so the count 2-0. Throw over to first, tag applied, but again late. Two-oh pitch taken for a strike. Manzo got the scoring started, an RBI double in the third. He tried to leg it out for two, but Kevin Mulholland on the dart to Eric Bowron, senior to senior, got Manzo out at second, so he got limited to a single. As the runner goes, a little fish of a swing, barehanded by Silent, throw to first in time. The hit and run works in the case of putting a runner in the scoring position. And it makes it two away here in the top of the fifth with Bradley Dixon due up. Dixon singled and flew out so far in his first two team at bat, his first two at bats. First pitch swinging, Lesher picks it up on a hop, on the charge, fires over to first, where Carpenter secures with the backhand scoop, and Charleston goes down here in the fifth. We're halfway through, Cougars 2, Hens 1.
Oh, say can you see two?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
So far, the only two base runners on for Delaware, a walk by Vinny Vaccone, a fielder's choice reach by Zach Lesher, as Zach Miller sends it over to short. A diving effort, the throw is in time. Foot on the bag, just in time after a diving effort at short. Luke Manzo trapping it on a hop, and then he gets the throw over where Ari Sakopoulos gets the foot in time to beat out Zach Miller. And just like that, a loud first out in the fifth. You can put a star in your scorecard on the 6-3. First pitch swinging for Vaccone, and he pops it up. Actually, has enough carried out to right field. So a fly out, two up, two down on two pitches. 6-3, F9. And now Zach Lesher due up.
Zach Lesher.
Lesher, he swings at the first pitch, but this one fouled out of play. Zach Williams has thrown 44 pitches at 4 2/3. Last year, thought about the bunt, pulls back, but it's a take and strike. And Williams right now in command. 0-2 the count, and Lesher fouls it away. Once again, the 0-2 in this lefty v lefty matchup. And Lesher bloops it out to center field for a base hit, the first of the game for Delaware. Griffin McLarty went six no-hit innings, was replaced in the seventh, and the relief pitcher Brooks Lucas allowed a single in his first AB. Here, Zach Williams goes 4 2/3 hitless to start before giving up his first of the game. So Lesher on the board with Delaware's first hit. Austin Colmary due up, and he takes the first pitch strike. Ball gets in the turf. Lesher goes, throw, gets into the outfield, but Lesher won't advance. Pitch was a ball, by the way. And so the count 1-1. So runner in scoring position for Colmary, who takes the ball. 8 RBI on the season for Austin. 184 hitter at runners in scoring position. Two, one, taking first strike. So a two-out single by Zach Lesher. Then the wild pitch gets him in scoring position. Can Delaware tie it up with a two-out rally? 2-2. And that one outside, ball three. The rare time of Williams working from the stretch. He's had 1-2-3 innings and 3 of the 5 Delaware team at-bats. Payoff pitch here, and Colmary sends it out to right, but a little bit of playing in makes it very easy for the grab by Bradley Dixon, and the inning comes to an end. So the first Delaware hit comes with 2 outs, but the Hens get nothing more. No runs, 1 hit, no errors, 1 left. We are through 5, and a 1-run ball. Joey Mundy leads off. And now the top of the sixth inning in a 1-run ball game. Joey Silen, he's allowed Seven base runners on, all by hits. Actually make that eight because he had one by hit by pitch, but he's been able to limit the damage. He gets a 1-3 ground out here to retire Mundy. And that's the thing about baseball is sometimes the hit disparity doesn't quite pile up to the run disparity. And for pitchers, it's very important for you to be able to work around damage. You can do the analytics and the sabermetrics and talk about hits leading to runs and what the expected run total is, but sometimes pitchers, they actually perform better with runners on. And the fortitude and the mental toughness for pitchers like that become oh so important in postseason play. Sylan's going to get two quick outs as Chaz Davey falls to 0 of 2 from the plate. Two up, two down in the sixth. Charleston 2, Delaware 1, the score. Harrison Hawkins due up. 0 of 2 with a run scored. And the first pitch by Joey Sylan is outside for a ball. That was the 70th pitch by Sylan. Trying to get through his sixth inning of work. And the 1-0 pitch also missed. So Sylan well behind in the count. But Sylan, he's been able to work deep into the game, especially as of late. Five times with triple digits in terms of total pitches, including four of his last six appearances. But a quick 1-2-3 inning in the sixth, and Delaware will come up to bat trying to tie things up when we return on Hens All Access.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Joey Sylan got through his first hitless inning of the game. Meanwhile, Zach Williams, he's allowed only one hit so far. A two-out single in the fifth by Zach Lesher. Kevin Mulholland leads things off. He has the lone Delaware RBI. And he takes a pitch outside for the ball. Today is senior day. Mulholland, one of the five seniors. Eric Bowen on deck, another one. But Brandon Walter also honored, along with Matt Rikicheski and Cole Benjamin. We'll in a bit go through the highlights of the ceremony. Probably do so during the seventh inning stretch. But a lot to celebrate about the class that is graduating for Delaware baseball. Mulholland gets the single to lead things off here in the sixth. This is a Delaware program that most recently won the Colonial Tournament in 2017 to make the NCAA Regionals, and obviously Mulholland a key part of that. First pitch taken by Bovren. Bovren playing here at Delaware in 2018 and 2019, but look at the likes of Brandon Walter. He unfortunately got injured midway through that 2017 season, but was a key part for that team nonetheless. Cole Benjamin had 10 appearances for that Colonial Conference winning team and had 14 innings pitched that year. And then also of note, Rick Kachansky was another one of the reserves for Delaware on that 2017 squad. It'll be a fly out here for Bowren, and there's one away. F7 in your scorecard. And Bowen now 0 of 3 at the plate. Jordan Hutchins due up. He's grounded out to third twice. First pitch swinging. He sends this out to left, but right in range for the catch. Just a few steps to the left for Joey Mundy. And there's quickly two away in the sixth. Back-to-back flyouts to left for the Hens, and Joseph Carpenter the last chance in this inning. Delaware, for the first time having its leadoff runner reach in the third, scored a run. Right now, that runner stranded at first on the second opportunity with a leadoff runner on. Mahalan gets back on a throw to first. Foul back. And to the count on one. I'll look to first, and the pitch, and Carpenter sends it into left for a base hit. So Joseph Carpenter gets a hit here. He will finish out his freshman season with hits in 37 of his last 42 games. And it really is a great freshman year for Carpenter, who has immediately provided presence as a great contact hitter in the middle parts of the lineup. Jack going with an RBI opportunity. Takes a first pitch ball outside. First time Delaware has strung together multiple hits in this game. And Goen sends it past the dive at short and to left for a base hit. Mulholland rounds third. He'll come home to score as Jack Goen has a game-tying RBI single. It's 2-2. Third time through the lineup's been the charm so far for Delaware against Zach Williams. They had just one hit two times through the lineup. In this third time, they already have three. And that's a beautiful thing about baseball. You have the ability to adjust in the middle of the game. And really, the elite pitchers that make it all the way to the MLB and become aces, one thing that they can do besides having great stuff is have a variety of stuff as they go deeper into the game. Now, it's not as common now, and maybe you interpret this as a shot at the progression of baseball at the major league level, but pitchers just aren't going as deep into games, so they can't do it as much. But back in the day when you had pitchers having complete games multiple times a year, that was a big asset, the ability to have a variety of looks and change it up, stay ahead of the batters second, third, maybe fourth time through the lineup. But it was a struggle for Zach Williams, third time through the lineup. And he will be taken out of the game with this now a tie ball game at 2 in the bottom of the sixth. We'll step off to a quick break. You're watching Hens All Access. Pitching change as Josh Price is on the bump. He got some well-deserved rest yesterday after pitching 6 shutout innings in the 16-inning marathon Thursday night. He is back on the bump now in a tie ball game to relieve Zach Williams. And Price, he entered this series as one of the top arms for the Cougars with a 3.36 ERA coming into the series. That dropped all the way down to 309 after the 6 shutout innings. He also has a 6-3 record, and he is making his 31st appearance of the season. 75 2/3 innings, that's the second highest on the staff behind Griffin McLarty. 26 earned runs allowed on 70 hits, 22 walks, 51 strikeouts. So just a very reliable arm for the Cougars. And Price, a product of Dillon, South Carolina, began his time at Florence Darlington Tech and is now here providing a big part for this Cougars side, which is trying to end the regular season on an 8-game winning streak heading into the Colonial Tournament play, which will be hosted by James Madison University. The book not yet closed on Zach Williams. When it is, we'll get you that total. But he goes 5 2/3 innings. And Zach Miller takes the ball. Miller firmly ahead in the count here. If Miller can get on, it will load the bases for Vinny Vaccone. All the way down for Price. He was looking in for his pitch. He has a wide windup, kind of a side release, but when he works from the stretch, he gets that top half of his body all the way down and then works from the stretch. And that's a walk to Zach Miller. 4 pitches for the walk. So the base is now chock full of them. Joseph Carpenter at third, Jack Goen at second, Zach Miller at first, and Vinny Vaccone due up. Vaccone 0-1 with a walk and a flyout. Price with his first pitch offering misses. One oh, and Bacone slices that down the right field line. This one will fall foul. There's a little too much slice to it. If it fell unfair, that's at least 2 runs, perhaps maybe 3. So the three hens will trot back to their respective bags as Vacone heads to the batter box once again, the batter's box, as a count 1-1. One misses low, and so Vacone ahead in the count. There are no open base paths here. And we'll have a quick meeting on the mound before we continue here in this plate appearance. The inning's still happening here, and the home plate umpire not yet breaking things up. And as soon as I say that, he will come out to end things. Two to one the count. Bases loaded, two outs, bottom six, in a 2-2 ball game. Day is over for Zach Williams after he went 5 2/3 innings. If runs come in to score in this inning, he'll be on the hook for the loss as the chopper gets above the pitcher, but right at the second base bag, it's picked up, 6 unassisted for the fielder's choice, and that ends the inning. So Delaware ties it up again, scoring 1 run on 3 hits. No errors and the bases left loaded. We go to the seventh, 2-2, the score on Hens All Access. Joey Silen has 72 pitches through 6 innings of work. He'll begin the seventh going up against Tanner Steffi as once again we're tied. Single runs in the third and the fourth by Charleston. Single runs in the third and sixth by Delaware. And if things seem to pan out the way, or if things pan out the way they seem they will, we could have another close one here at Bob Hanna Stadium. We've had them throughout the last 2 weekends. Steffi, 2 of 2 with a single and RBI double, ahead in the count 2-0. And he takes a strike. So the book over for Zach Williams will get you his ledger when Delaware comes up to bat after the stretch. Silence pitch 2-1 gets away from the gear of Jack going and the count 3-1. Called strike two. That nearly was looking like it was going to be inside for ball four. Beginning the step and the toss, Steffi got held back. And so now the count full. Silent. With the pitch. And that's fouled away. Payoff pitch again, and that got in tight. Squirts away from going. There will be no quick running here for Steffi. But he's reached safely three times in as many plate appearances, and he draws the first walk of the game from Joey Silent. Silent was coming off his first hitless inning on the game, first 1-2-3 inning. The leadoff walk, and we'll see if that becomes trouble. As Charleston has a pinch runner for Tanner Steffi, and a speedy one at that. And it's Nick Roland. Roland pinch ran on Thursday and was trying his best to wreak some havoc on the base paths, a definite threat to steal. So Tanner Steffi's day is over, but a very effective one at that. As Charleston, they're going to try and squeeze in one more run here and see if that's enough for the win. Throw to first. Tag applied late. Hofstra leads William and Mary 4-0, top six. And that would be the most interesting outcome. If William and Mary beats Hofstra, you know who the six teams in the tournament are. Joining Elon, Charleston, and Northeastern would be William and Mary, James Madison, and UNCW. As those last three teams all 11-12 in league play, but Hofstra 10-13. If they win, it opens things up for what's to come at 2:00 between James Madison and UNCW. That would be the rubber match of that series, and it would put into play a three-way tie with the Pride. And three-way tie, with the Pride and the Tribe for the losing team. I had it correct the first time. Ari Sakopoulos, the batter, has a 2-1 count. One on, nobody out. And that is a breaking ball swung early and driven foul into the Charleston bullpen. So now the count 2-2, and we'll see if Silent will try to change speeds up after that was read well, but read early. Two-two sent out to left field, still tracking back, but Hutchins locates the ball and makes the catch. So one away after the F7. And there'll be a pinch hitter for Jared Kervin after a 1-of-2 day at the plate with Kervin's first career double
But Danny Wondrak is now the batter. Wondrak had the game-tying home run Thursday with two outs in the top of the ninth. And that was obviously a very painful moment for what was eventually a 16-inning loss for the Hens. Actually, the last pitch from Brandon Walters' 2019 campaign. And that was the 14th home run of the season for Wondrak. On the season, besides the 14 home runs, Wondrak a .322 batter. His on-base plus slugging, 1,001. And he takes the ball to go ahead and the count 2-0. It'd take a different outcome in either that game on Thursday or one of the two that were lost with Delaware leading early against Hofstra last weekend. And this one could have been for a potential tournament spot. But the Hens, they get out of this inning 5-4-3, and they keep this one tied in the season finale. Time the stretch, but as we continue here, we want to remind you today, Senior Day for Delaware, and five seniors were honored before the game, and Kevin Mulholland, Eric Borim, Matt Rikicheski, Cole Benjamin, and Brandon Walter. And here we have the highlights from this Senior Day. And obviously great contributions by these players. Mulholland being now tied for the most appeared Blue Hen in program history. Borim, 2 years after transferring from Mercer County. Cole Benjamin as a relief pitcher and his time with the Hens. Rikicheski as a backup catcher. And then Brandon Walter end up being a top arm, if not the top arm, during his time with Delaware, particularly this year. In 2019, he was the ace of the staff and one of four Hens with triple digits in terms of strikeouts in a single season. So we had our stretch here, a chance for you to see what happened on Senior Day and getting ready for the bottom of the seventh inning here, tied at two. Josh Price back on the bump after a walk, and then inducing the final out on the six unassisted fielder's choice. This game is tied with the Hens having an opportunity for a late win in its season finale. Leading off for the Blue Hens. Meanwhile, Charleston already 35 wins in the books, the best win-loss record of any Colonial team, best win-loss record of any Division I team from South Carolina. Well, they're hoping to make it an 8-game winning streak heading into tournament play. And they've had a lot of those of the close variety as of late. Maybe you could be a little bit concerned that they've had to stretch out some close ones, but I think in terms of the battle-tested toughness, the Cougars have passed with flying colors. Zach Lesher fouls off a first pitch offering. He's one of two with a single, which in the bottom of the fifth was the first hit of the game for Delaware. 0-1 pitch, and that's taken inside for a ball. Price quickly works the 1-1. Again, he has that long stance on the windup. And it's a strike to make the count 1-2. Lesher slowly rolling foul ball on the chopper. The count remains 1-2. William and Mary has a pair on the board in the top of the sixth to cut the deficit to 4-2. Northeastern no score against Towson in the top of the third. The Huskies win in Baltimore, and they will secure the number 3 seed. Last year makes it a multi-hit game. And he gets the leadoff single. Each of the first two leadoff runners to reach for Delaware have scored. Vacone in the third, Mahalan in the sixth. And so Zach Lesher is batting about 155 16 games ago. But he's going to have a lot of improvement to that batting average down the stretch here. Austin Colmeri foul, tips the bunt, and it's a strike. See if Colmeri tries again for the bunt. Squares again and misses this time. Count quickly 0-2. Colmeri successfully sacrificed in the third. Flew out in the fifth. Lesher at first after his fifth multi-hit game of the season. Colmeri goes down on strikes and there's one away. Unable to get that bunt. And so the lineup flips over for Kevin Mulholland, who last time up got career hit number 242. First pitch, misses in tight. Charleston with 2 runs on 7 hits, no errors through 17 at-bats. Delaware trying to complete its 7th to add on to its 2 runs, 5 hits, and no errors. 1-0, and Mulholland sends it to short. Let's see if it's 2. He gets it over to second for 1, not in time for 2. 6-4 on the fielder's choice. And there's 2 away. So Mulholland now 1-4. As Eric Bowren due up. Bowren 0-3 so far at the plate. Price working from the stretch. Throws it over to first. Big bend forward to decide what he wants for the pitch. Back up for Price. And the first pitch offering is taken for a strike. First time Bowren is seeing Price today against Zach Williams. He grounded out twice, once to third, once to short, and flew out to left field. Oh, one, and again, this is sent left side. Charge by Manzo, throw is wide, and that's not going to be on the bag in time for Sakopoulos. Bowren makes it 2 on, 2 outs. For Jordan Hutchins, the team's leading RBI hitter with 42 on the season. We'll wait for official ruling on that play, whether it's a hit or an error. And it indeed will be an E6. So any runs that score in this inning will be unearned. And Delaware hoping there will be at least one. And an agreement here in the booth on the scoring play, E6. Hutchins swings and misses at the 1-0 offering. Well, let's see what Delaware can do. Charleston over the first two games was absolutely huge with two outs. 9 RBIs, and then there was a 10th play that was a scoring play, but no RBI on the play. Hutchins sends it over to short, and this time the throw on the button by Luke Manzo. So Delaware gets a hit, has one reach on an error, but scored no runs and leave two on base, and we're tied at 2-7. Pitching change as the day over for Joey Silen, and it's a quality start. And the last 2019 appearance for the freshman, 2 earned runs allowed on 7 hits, 1 walk, no strikeouts over 7 innings of work. Pretty much even matchup coming in with Zach Williams, and Williams, he allowed 2 runs earned on 4 hits, a walk, a strikeout over 4 2/3. So that has gotten us to an even 2-2 game, and the new pitcher for Delaware is Jack Dubick, a fellow freshman. Right-handed pitcher Dubick, and he hails from right here in Newark, Delaware, product of St. Mark's, 6'1", 180, and he brings into this game the following numbers for Delaware. 2-4 record, 3.56 ERA, 2.54 batting average allowed. His first pitch offering is a ball to Luke Stagerberg. But Dubeck, over 48 innings, has allowed 19 earned runs on 47 hits, 13 walks, 25 strikeouts, and he's been working both in relief and as a starter in both Colonial and non-conference play. Stagerberg, 1-2. With a single, he swings and misses at this offering to make the count 1-2. But a nice way to finish the season for Joey Silen. Another pitcher who's been both in relief and starting, as this is a called strike 3 on the appeal. So he strike out swinging, and Dubeck gets the first K for Delaware pitching in this game. But yeah, Silen,
now batting number one, Luke,
in terms of his starting work, entered the game right about a 6 ERA. Dips that a little bit below that as a starter. It's been kind of either or between him and Dubeck. Also, Chris Ledman thrown in a few relief appearances, but first pitch strike here to Manzo, and quickly the count 0-2 after the foul. Dubeck starting things off on the right foot. A St. Mark's teammate and Legion 1 teammate of Chris Ludman. And again, American Legion World Series champions last year for post one. But Dubek, he's kept his ERA sub four after every appearance, and this is freshman season. So he's been a steady arm. This goes deep in the hole, but Cone won't have a throw. It's an infield single for Luke Manzo, and he's 2-4 now from the plate. Eighth hit of the game for the Cougars.
Now batting number three, Bradley Dixon.
Second Charleston player with multiple hits. Bradley Dixon now up to bat. Dixon, one of three. And before he faces a pitch, should throw over to first. Top of the eighth inning here. And Dubek with a first pitch strike. I think all said for this Delaware side. The transition from upperclassmen to underclassmen has really panned out this year. Yes, growing pains, some frustrations and disappointments, but in a year like this, generally comes successful years up ahead. Beautiful off-speed stuff. Swung on and missed. When you look at underclassmen that have gotten considerable playing time. Hutchins, Carpenter, Miller, Lesher, Colmary, Dubek, Wakely. Well, Wakely's a junior. But Ludman, Haas, Allen, all come to mind. You can even include the transfers who, like Wakely and Goen, even Vacone, if you want to throw that in there, have had their first or second years this season with Delaware, and the way things all have the potential to come together moving into the future. 0-2 was a bit in tight. And so the count now 1-2. And that's low and away to even it up. It's a tie ball game, by the way, out in Hempstead, New York. William and Mary, four runs in the top of the sixth to equal the four runs in the bottom of the fourth against the Pride. It's still a chance for the Tribe to score. Runners on the corners with two outs in that inning. And it just got updated. They got a single. And I think there might have been an out recorded on the base paths. But a 5-4 lead now for the Tribe middle six. Two to the count. Double play depth for Delaware. And this is fouled away by Dixon. Talk about Delaware's underclassmen for Charleston. They're a very experienced team. A lot of key seniors and juniors on the team. And while that doesn't necessarily mean that their window will close after this year, you would have to think that this is a prime opportunity for them to try to make a return trip to the NCAA tournament. Dixon pops out, P4. And there's two away in the top of the eighth, tied at two.
Now batting number eight, Joey Mundy. Joey
Mundy due up. One of three with a double. Dubek's been paying a lot of attention to Luke Manzo at first. Here, though, first pitch offering a rip and a miss. And the count to Mundy is 0-1. I'll look to first. Dubek working from the stretch. And the 0-1 pitch is fouled back, so now the count 0-2. Two outs in the top of the eighth. Delaware trying to keep it a tie game to earn an opportunity to win in their last team at bat. Middle third of the lineup due in the bottom of the eighth. Carpenter, Goen, Miller. Carpenter and Goen had the two-out rally in the sixth to tie it up. 0-2. Slight there, pitch out. Maybe thinking about trying to get Manzo if he tried to steal, maybe even try to get some chase. But either way, now the count 1-2. And the 1-2 pitch, that is sent out to center field. Mahalan on the range. Secures a grab. And that'll end things in the eighth for the Cougars. So Charleston with no runs on one hit, no errors, one left. Delaware coming up to bat in a tie ball game on Hens All Access.
America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Joseph Carpenter will try to get things going on the right foot for Delaware. They've had back-to-back innings with leadoff singles. Scoring a run in the sixth, going scoreless in the seventh. We're in the eighth, tied at two. So if Delaware grabs the lead here, maybe an opportunity to close it in the next half inning. Carpenter takes a first pitch ball. So we have another close game down to the wire here at Bob Hanna Stadium. Carpenter leads it off with a line too short, and there's one away.
Now batting the catcher, number 44, Jack Goen.
Jack Goen up to bat. He's one of three with an RBI single. Finishing things out very strong over his last 19 games. A very accomplished player at the Division III level of junior college baseball, was the NJCAA Division III Player of the Year last year at Rowan Gloucester. And to be honest, struggled at the plate to start off this his first year of Division I baseball, but by the end. He's very much earned his spot as a day-to-day player in the lineup. Slices this one to right field, but it's going to be in range to be caught by the right fielder. And Bradley Dixon, two up, two down in the eighth.
Number 22, the designated hitter, Zach Miller.
Zach Miller is now the batter. The Delaware designated hitter today, 0 of 2 with a walk. And how about Josh Price? If he can get this next out, it'll be 8 1/3 scoreless innings against Delaware in this series. Off speed, an early swing and a miss for Miller. Price, very adept this year at closing out innings. He has a batting average allowed of 198 with two outs. Miller sends this foul down the left field line. Sends this back up the middle. Diving effort, not going to get there for Manzo. And so Miller with a hit in his season finale.
Now batting the shortstop, number 10.
Delaware now has six hits in the game from five different players. And there'll be a pinch runner for Miller. And we will see Brad Caden in this pinch running scenario. Miller the DH, so no defensive replacements necessary. First pitch to Vinny Vaccone is taken for a ball. And McCone fouls this one off, so they count 1-1. It's been a beautiful day, really a beautiful weekend of weather here in the first state. 1-1, swing and miss. Makes it count 1-2. A pitcher perfect Thursday. Yesterday had a brief threat of maybe precipitation, but that was it. And today, just a few clouds. One, two pitches fouled away. And so Vinny Vaccone stays alive. 0 of 2 with a walk and a run scored. Runner goes, and another foul ball. That happening with the 1-2 count. Again, Vaccone fouls it away. Nice battle brewing here between Vinny Vaccone and Josh Price. Vaccone trying to finish off his 2019 campaign with a multi-hit game. One, two again, and Vaccone slices that foul. That time over to the Charleston pen. And we'll give it one more go. The count, 1-2. A lunge forward, back up for Price, and the pitch fouled again. That's now 5. Two-strike pitches fouled away by Vicone. One, two, inside, and the count is even. 10th pitch of the at-bat coming up. As the innings eater, Josh Price, trying to make another scoreless frame. And Vicone fouls it away yet again. Just trying to find one to turn the screws on. And again, he fouls it away. So 7, 2-strike pitches fouled away. And the 12th pitch of this appearance coming up, this battle between Josh Price and Vinny Vicone. We'll try the 2-2 once again. And that's sent over to second to end the inning. So Delaware gets a 2-out single and nothing more. We head to the 9th, all knotted up at 2. Dubik back on the bump in a tie ball game. Top of the 9th we go. Middle third of the lineup due for Charleston. Davian Hawkins will start. Tanner Steffi was pinch run for by Nick Roland. We'll see if there is either Roland or somebody else to bat. But the first pitch is a tank and strike by Chaz Davey, who is 0 of 2 with a reach via hit by pitch. Quickly, the count now 0-2. And this fouled away. Dubik allowed just a 1-out single in the 8th. Working quickly here. And had a pitch that didn't miss by much. Get that follow through there for a second, hoping maybe the ball will be changed to a strike, but no luck there. Early swing and a foul ball by Davey. Keeps the count 1-2. Quick foul back. And now we have a good battle here brewing between Chaz Davey and Jack Dubek. Then after the Vinny Vaccone battle went a long way against Josh Price. Here, though, a swing and a miss. Dubek beginning each of his first two innings with strikeouts swinging. So a second K of the game, and there's one away.
Now batting number 10, Harrison Hawkins.
Harrison Hawkins, the batter. Hawkins 0 of 3 with a run scored. Fouls off the first pitch. Oh, 1, and that pitch misses for a ball. This will be sent over to short on the charge. The throw by Vaccone, one hopper scooped up by Carpenter. 2 up, 2 down in the top of the ninth. So Hawkins now 0 of 4. Davey 0 of 3. And when you have a pinch runner come in, the last time for a designated hitter, you don't know until that next plate appearance comes up to confirm the switch, and that will be the case with Logan McRae due up. McRae blew yesterday's game wide open with a 2-out, 3-run homer off of Chris Ludman. That marked his 34th career home run. Top 6 in Charleston history. Ding back to 1991. Pitch is taken for a strike. And a ball now to even the count. But Logan McRae, a 266 hitter. This season, 9 homers, 34 RBI, 16 doubles. Count is now 1-2. And that is sent out to right center for a base hit. McRae, he's actually going to try for 2. Never showed any hesitation, and he legs out a double. So forget a single base hit. Let's make it a multi-base hit. And just like that, with 2 outs, potential go-ahead run in scoring position.
Now batting number 11, Ari Sakopoulos.
Ari Sakopoulos is the batter. He's 0 of 3 today. Sakopoulos this season with runners in the scoring position hitting 192. Sends this over to first and squirts off the glove of Carpenter. A big round of third. Here comes the throw home, and it's wide. Sakopoulos is heading to second. A late run to get there, but the throw wide as well, and it's 3-2 Charleston. Well, it looked like maybe an opportunity to send it into the ninth, maybe a chance to win it, but the Delaware defense for the first time today goes awry at the most ill-fitted time. Not an easy play to make by any stretch of the imagination, but Delaware just wasn't able to locate the ball in time, and then the throw went wide home. It could have been in time to get out McRae, who once again showed his aggressiveness on the base paths. Remember, he legged out that double out to right center. And that first pitch swing by Danny Wondrak hits off the base of the wall. Another run will come in to score. Wondrak will make it 4-2 as Sakopoulos heads home. So it was E3 for Sakopoulos to reach. Then an E4 for his advancement to second.
Now batting number 23, Luke Steigerberg.
And then that followed up with the RBI double on the first pitch swinging by Danny Wondrak. It's going to be unearned runs for Dubek as now Wondrak heads to third. Things going south rather quickly for Dubek and the Hens. And unfortunately, just the last two weekends, there have been a multitude of opportunities for Delaware, but they have gone not in their favor in the tightest of spots. And now they have the potential of being swept here in this series. As Luke Steigerberg ahead in the count 2-0, he's one of three with a single. Make it 3-0 for the count. It's officially ruled a passed ball. That got Wondrak to third. And make it a walk here to Steigerberg. Delaware just trying to get out of this inning. Give the team a chance for a comeback. And was again, two out damage. No RBI on the run scored for McCray, but then the double and the RBI for Wondrak marks the 10th two out RBI of the series for Charleston. And they enter the series having a lot of their production with two outs, 25 over the previous 10. There's a pinch runner who goes, and that is an easy stolen base. Second all-time in a single season for Dupree Hart. See, a lot of the guys, top guys for Charleston, not get the start. But still come in, McCray, Wondrak, and Hart. Dupree Hart now has 40 stolen bases, I believe, on the season. Just the second time in program history someone's done that in a single season for Charleston. And the count here, 3-1 to Luke Manzo. So Jack Dubek running into trouble here. Trying to get out of the jam. Bunt attempt to stab was fouled by Manzo, who's 2-of-4 with a pair of singles and an RBI. Three-two, and that's fouled away. In the bottom of the ninth for Delaware, they'll have hitters 8-9-1 due up Lesher, Colmery, and Mulholland, who have a combined three hits and 12 at-bats. Payoff pitch, misses, ball four. And it's now loaded for Bradley Dixon.
Now batting number three, Bradley Dixon.
Change. And we'll have a pitching change coming up here. Things looked good through an inning and two-thirds for Jack Dubik, but after the error, things kind of unraveled for him. And Delaware, in still a close game, 4-2, will try to get the last out when we return on Hens All Access. The new pitcher for Delaware is Tommy Pomato, a freshman right-hander. And a product of Camden, Wyoming, Delaware. Pomato, the third arm for the Hens today, trying to get the last out, and he brings into the game the following numbers for Delaware. He has a 1-0 record of 7.2 ERA, a batting average allowed of 3.03. 8 earned runs allowed over 10 innings of work, and 7 appearances including a start, 8 walks, 4 strikeouts. There's also a pinch runner now at third, McClendon Sears, on for Charleston, placing Danny Wondrak. First pitch swinging, and it's a miss for Bradley Dixon. One, and that's fouled back. So Pomato trying to make it a very brief outing here. To close out his year. Oh, 2, fastball misses out. Chopper over to third. Lesher only has, well, no throw. Run comes in to score. Now he goes home. And Dupree Hart in a pickle. Hart tries a spin, but gets tagged out. But a third run comes in to score. We'll situate that scoring play when we return after this. But Delaware, last chance to get on the board, trailing by 3 in the season finale. So there's a lot to unpack, and almost hiccuped myself there for a second, but there's a lot to unpack at the end of that top of the ninth play where a run came in to score and then there was an out. So it's a fielder's choice reach and advancement to second, and then Dupree Hart goes out 3-2-6-1 to get an unearned run to come in to score. And this was an alert play by Zach Lesher after knowing he did not have a throw anywhere. Charleston's been very aggressive on the base paths. Why not try to get that second runner out trying to come home? So again, 5-2-6-1. Dupree was out. And it was indeed an RBI on the fielder's choice reach by Bradley Dixon. But Delaware now has one down. Zach Lesher and Austin Colmery is the next batter. 5-2 the score and Delaware's season finale. We have also two defensive replacements to talk about. First pitch is a strike taken. Charleston ended up closing out the book in the ninth with three runs scored on two hits, two errors, and two left on base. Colmery behind the count 1-2 against actually a new pitcher as well. And that in Chris Kuhn. And it's a swing and a miss. Two up, two down. Back-to-back strikeouts swinging as Kuhn looking for the save. Let's get you the numbers for him. As Kevin Mulholland, the senior, perhaps the last at-bat of the season for Delaware. And quite in a fitting fashion, four-year starter at center field. Tied for the most games appeared as a Delaware Blue Hen. Takes a strike. But Kuhn making his 16th appearance, no record, 6.11 ERA, 2.28 batting average allowed in 28 innings, 19 earned runs allowed on 23 hits, 22 walks, 29 strikeouts. Dupree Hart stayed at second. Harrison Hawkins goes into left. And the new center fielder is, I believe, the man who pinch ran for Danny Wondrak. And that was McClendon Sears. One to the count. And Mulholland fouls it away. Mulholland today has a 1-for-4 day, a hit in an RBI. And that pitch misses away, ball two. Well, Charleston one out away from having its 21st come-from-behind win this season. No, I actually stand corrected. They never trailed in this game. It was tied at one, tied at two, and two leads for Charleston. But still 20 this season, nonetheless good. Mulholland sends it out to right. The grab is made, and that'll do it. As Charleston comes into Delaware, and they get the sweep, they'll head into the Colonial Tournament on an 8-game winning streak. The Cougars with the 5-2 win. They will end up improving things to a 36 win total this regular season, and 19 losses, 16-8 in Colonial play. Delaware finishes out its season 21-33 overall, 9-15 and Colonial play. Your winning pitcher in this one ends up being Josh Price, and the pitcher with the save, Chris Kuhn. Meanwhile, the losing pitcher, albeit not allowing an earned run, Chris Dubeck. In the game, Charleston gets 5 runs on 10 hits, 1 error, left 6 on base. Delaware with 2 runs on 6 hits with 2 errors and 8 left on base. We want to thank everybody again who tuned in, not just this game, not just this weekend, but this season here on Hens All Access. We very much appreciate your support throughout the year, and we hope you'll join us once again in the upcoming seasons for the 2019-2020 athletic season that's to be coming up. But the final here from Bob Hanna Stadium, Charleston 5, Delaware 2. This has been a production of Hens All Access. Adam Dobrovolsky signing off and wishing you a happy summer.